Hey guys, so I wanted to do a quick video about winding yarn. So whenever you purchase yarn, it typically comes in a skein. This is called a skein of yarn. And if you undo the skein, it's folded like this. So these little threads are put here to keep it together so it doesn't become a big ball of yarn barf, which we don't want. And then it's twisted together and then into a pretty skein. It's really pretty like this. It shows off all the colors, but this is a custom order that I'm getting started on. So we're going to wind it. And I wanted to share this process with you. So over here, I have my Swift, which doesn't want to cooperate. So we put the yarn on the Swift, and I'm going to cut my threads with my little scissors. So this is just the thread that was holding all of these strands together to keep from making a giant mess. And I can wind yarn if you have purchased yarn from me in the shop. I can wind it for you. You just have to make sure that you leave me a note in the purchase order. There's a little section that says that you can leave notes. So just make sure you leave me a note, and that way I can make sure that I wind it for you. If it's over three balls though, or over three skeins into little cakes or balls, there is a charge for it because it does take a while to wind all of it up. So this is the best winder I've ever had. It's by Fiber Artist Supply. Love it. It's handmade out of wood. This guy hand makes all of these. This is his own system. It's got a little pulley here, and it's all made out of wood and metal. Totally love it. So I will start winding. And this is how yarn gets wound. And this particular ball winder or cake winder, some people call them cakes of yarn, some people call them balls. A ball to me is something that's more round, like a circular thing, and the cakes, I'll show you when this one is done, the cakes come out and they almost have like, they're round on the outside, but they're kind of flat on the top and bottom. So they look like little mini cakes. And I need to oil this thing a little bit because it is a little squeaky. But we just keep winding and winding and winding. So this is one skein of yarn, and this is how it's wound up into a little cake. So we're gonna keep winding and keep winding. I've had this Swift for years. This was actually when I first started getting really serious with knitting. I was desperate to have my own little setup. And my original setup, if you go back in the YouTube videos, I have a setup where I showed you, it used to be in my bathroom, and I would stretch it from like one side of the big tub to the other side, and I would have a ball winder. But I had a little plastic ball winder that was given to me as a gift, and it was nothing like this one, not as good. Okay, so we are done. Look at that, is that not beautiful? And then this just slides right off. And here we have a beautiful cake of yarn. We just stuff in these little pieces at the top. See how pretty that is? And this is gonna be our end that we're gonna start working with. So I'm so excited to start this. This is going to be a hat. This is gonna be the Shannon Slouchy hat. And I will try to share updates and do videos to keep you posted. Thanks for watching.